Hi, I'm Craig Rowland, founder of Sandfly Security. Today, I'm going to talk to you about a very serious but common threat on Linux, and that's unencrypted SSH private keys. Now, of course, SSH keys are probably the most ubiquitous way for people to access Linux systems for administration tasks, but it's very, very easy to get lazy with how those keys are being secured. And one of the most common things people do is they leave a private key after they generate it inside mission critical accounts on Linux. Now, what's going to happen here is if that system were to get compromised, that key is going to expose you to very serious risk of lateral movement attack. So we'll start our demonstration here by going over to Sandfly, and we'll start in the Sandfly UI, and then we're going to switch over to the command line to show you some of the things that are going on under the covers here. But basically, we've scanned a host here called Sandfly Victim, and it's come back with 8 alerts. Now, these 8 alerts are combined here into these 4 high-level alerts. This is what we call an alert stack, but we find several things here of interest. First of all, private key is unencrypted in SSH user directory, which is what we're here to talk about today. We have a policy check that identified the same thing. We found another policy check of finding a private key in an SSH directory, as well as another file check. Now, the reason here we have these multiples of it is we're looking for 2 different things. One is we're just simply looking for the presence of an SSH private key. Now, that key might be encrypted, and maybe that's okay. Generally speaking, I don't like leaving private keys around, even if encrypted, because attackers can grab them and then run an offline brute force attack against those keys, just as you would any password, and they can often get access to them because people pick bad passwords. But the other thing they do here is they really want to find private keys that are unencrypted, and this is actually very, very common. So what we did here on this directory here is we found 2 users that have an unencrypted key. Unencrypted keys are common on Linux, especially for automated machine-to-machine type activities, such as automated backups or admin tasks and things like that, because many times it's difficult to send in the password into your scripts or whatever you have going on in order to use the key. Or even if you encrypt it, you're frequently having to put the password in some type of plain text capacity in the script in order to use the key. So you're still in trouble there. But what we do here is we found a couple different users, one under the root directory, one under the home admin directory. And essentially what we did is we find that the file home admin SSH IDRSA is an SSH private key without a passphrase. We have the time that it was created. And basically we explain here that private keys can be used by attackers to enable lateral movement. So the lateral movement piece, how is that going to happen? Let's go to the terminal over here, and we're going to show you a few things. First of all, let's just pretend someone got onto this box through any mechanism you can come up with. It might be a web exploit. It could be someone got a password hacked, whatever it is. One of the first things that they're going to do is they're just going to run a simple find command like this. And there are a lot of scripts out there that can actually automate this, but for today's demonstration, we're just going to do it the old-fashioned way. And we're going to search the whole hard drive for anything named ID underbar RSA, which is a default private key name for SSH keys, and we're going to run it. Now, immediately here, I get 2 hits back, homeadmin.ssh/idrsa, and I found a root key. So basically, I have hit total pay dirt. 2 accounts here, likely with privileged access, are going to be found. We're going to go to the admin directory because that's going to have some things of interest here. Now, we do have, under our SSH, I see my IDRSA key here. Now, what you're wondering is, what are people going to do in order to find out where this key can be used? Well, let me go up a directory here, and I'm gonna cut out the bash history file for this user, and look right here. Here I could see 2 accounts where they're SSHing in as the admin. Of course, you could, you know, this is made for demonstration purposes, but you can grep this out and find out all the SSH areas that people are connected to. This is one place that people are gonna look. The other way they're gonna do it is they're gonna go to the SSH directory, and they're going to look at your authorized keys file. And here we have an authorized key file, obviously, but many times the comment might have where that key was generated. So here, what I see here is that this key might have been generated on a host initially 192.168.1.1. So I have another IP address to go. Another thing that they're going to do is they're going to cat out your known host file. So under the known host file here, I cat that out and I could see again some IP addresses that this person's been connecting to. Now, SSH frequently will have something called a mask turned on. And what I mean by that is that the IP addresses will be hashed with a simple, I think a SHA-1 hash in order to obscure what they are. Some people keep it enabled, some people keep it disabled. In this case here, if I look at SSH config, I could see here that hash known host has been disabled on this particular host. So now that's why these are visible for me to see. The masking, the hashing of it, it's a stopgap. It's not a great solution. It's been in SSH for a long time. I would not rely on it to do anything private, but there you go. Now, finally, the last thing they might do is they might look at your SSH config file. So in this case, we have an SSH config file. Yep, again, I have my host address. I could see this whole 192.168 subblock is going to have this user admin on it, so I could initiate a scan. Finally here, I could see, oh, there's a host called backups, and this is on a different subnet, the .3 over here, so I have that. And finally here, hit real pay dirt because there's a git host. And here, I'm able to log in as git admin with this key. So at this point, you're going to have a really, really, really big problem here. Now, getting back over to the Sandfly side of things, we've been able to pull this information up and show you very quickly in any of your hosts agentlessly that these keys are lying around, that they're going to cause trouble. Something else, which I'm going to touch on very briefly here, but we're really not going to get into today, is we have the ability to track these SSH keys. So I could see these SSH keys on this host. If I go to my Sandfly victim host here, I could see the four keys that are active on it. Over here, I can see also all the users that have keys on it. Here's some users here that are odd. For instance, this user games has a key, which I'll talk about in another video why that shouldn't happen. But the main thing here is we want to give you full access and visibility into what's going on with SSH. So a couple things here just to watch out for. Private keys, SSH private keys lying around, very, very big problem, very, very common problem, and guaranteed way to get yourself smashed in the face with a lateral movement attack. Unencrypted private keys are extremely high priority threat. I recommend you check your systems and get rid of them as quickly as possible. And finally, the last thing here too is just assume that if you had a system that's compromised and that system had private keys on it, you must assume the attacker has those keys, that those keys are compromised, and that you need to go to every host that that key might have had access to and immediately assess it for incident response purposes. So that's a quick overview of unencrypted SSH private keys and some of the risks they pose. I'm Craig Rowland from Sandfly Security. Check out our other videos and please subscribe to our social media channels for more information on topics relating to Linux forensics, intrusion detection, malware, and everything else Linux security related. Thanks again for watching and bye.